With 7,000 surface-to-air missiles, 10,000 anti-aircraft artillery guns, and a massive fleet of Mirage F1s, Su-24s, MiG-25s, and MiG-29s, the Iraqi anti-aircraft defense network was practically impenetrable by conventional means. However, U.S. forces had at their disposal the EF-111A Raven, and it was anything but conventional. As the most advanced electronics warfare warplane on Earth, the Raven had the ability to do the impossible. Piercing the Iraqi border at Mach 2.2 speeds with the other fighters, the Raven could unleash a storm of electronic chaos, turning Iraq's priceless AAA system into a paperweight for a brief time. Armed with the cutting-edge AN/ALQ-99E jamming system nestled in a pod that took the place of the F-111's traditional bomb bay, the Raven had the power to blind enemy radars and scramble communications across a broad spectrum, turning her into a force of nature. But the Raven's arsenal didn't stop there. She was also kitted out with the Terminal Threat Warning System, an advanced suite providing real-time threat detection and situational awareness through a massive receiver attached to the tail that gave the EF-111 its unmistakable profile and iconic look. Unmatched in electronic warfare, the Raven burst into the first-ever operation of the Gulf War, a high-stakes gamble to destroy Saddam Hussein's precious AAA network. Yet, for all of its might, the Raven had one weakness. It was not armed with a single conventional weapon. In the heat of combat, an enemy Mirage F1 somehow intercepted one of the Ravens. About to be obliterated, the crew would have to resort to extraordinary measures and push their warbird to the absolute limits if they were to survive. After months of simmering tension, the U.S.-led coalition was locked, loaded, and ready to kick off the opening salvo of Iraq in the historical Operation Desert Storm. Following decades of Cold War standoffs and skirmishes across the globe, this showdown was set to pull back the curtain on modern warfare, showcasing to the world the full might of Western powers in a new era of battle. Yet Iraq wasn't just sitting ducks. Compared to the colossal force amassing at its gates, its military might seemed dwarfed. However, it was anything but defenseless. Boasting a vast and cutting-edge anti-aircraft network, Iraq's defenses were an imposing hurdle for coalition forces. Crafted with expertise from French defense giant Thompson CSF, the Iraqi Integrated Air Defense System, IADS, dubbed KARI, meshed French and Soviet tech into a robust shield designed to fend off air attacks involving up to 40 strike aircraft. Gone were the days when U.S. forces could simply dispatch bombers flanked by fighter jets to obliterate Iraqi defenses. Such a move would lead their aircraft straight into a death trap, shredded by Iraq's arsenal of 7,000 surface-to-air missiles, 10,000 anti-aircraft artillery pieces, and hundreds of warplanes standing guard to protect their homeland. Yet the U.S. was not one to tread old ground. In anticipation of such challenges, it had doubled down on electronic warfare technology, culminating in the birth of the EF-111A Raven. This bird of prey was engineered to dismantle the intricacies of vast defense systems like the IADS. Evolving from the F-111 Aardvark, a multi-role combat aircraft that first took to the skies in the 1960s, the Raven was built on a war-proven foundation. With its variable sweep wings, the F-111 was initially conceived as a fighter bomber. Its adaptability and forward-thinking features made it an ideal candidate for transformation into a role as crucial as electronic warfare, proving once again that innovation and adaptability are key to mastering the skies. In 1972, the U.S. Air Force teamed up with Grumman to retrofit 42 F-111, as into state-of-the-art electronic warfare aircraft, aiming to outclass the Douglas EB-66E destroyer, a veteran of electronic countermeasures from the Vietnam conflict era. The Air Force was gunning for a leap forward with this project, selecting a supersonic jet as the new base frame, stripping it of conventional armaments, and outfitting it with a revolutionary suite of electronic gadgets and countermeasures designed to actively disrupt and dominate enemy electronic systems on the battlefield. This transformation required sweeping changes to both the airframe and the avionics. While the new bird retained the F-111's original navigation system, it boasted an upgraded AN/APQ-160 radar for superior ground mapping capabilities. Central to its mission, the Raven was armed with the AN/ALQ-99E jamming system, an evolution of the Navy's ALQ-99 found on the Prowler. It also featured the ALR-62 countermeasures receiving system, acting as a radar homing and warning system. This gear represented the cream of the crop in electronic warfare, offering both shield and sword in the electromagnetic arena. With a two-man crew comprising a pilot and an electronic warfare officer, EWO, the EF-111's mission was to shield strike forces from the prying eyes of enemy radar and the threat of surface-to-air missiles. It performed this task by jamming and fooling enemy radar networks despite carrying no weapons of its own. Cutting-edge tech comes with its set of challenges, notably the size. The ALQ-99E's core systems took over the weapons bay, and its transmitters were housed in a sizable 16-foot canoe mounted on the plane's belly. Weighing in at over 6,000 pounds, the electronic warfare gear required significant upgrades to the F-111's electrical and cooling systems to manage the load. The cockpit underwent a complete redesign to accommodate the new warfare role. Flight and navigation displays were consolidated on the pilot's side with flight controls, barring the throttles, removed from the co-pilot station, now the domain of the EWO's controls and instruments. This metamorphosis birthed a supersonic electronic warfare juggernaut tasked with safeguarding American aviators by neutralizing radars and sensors deep in hostile territory. In its final iteration, this aircraft achieved a top speed of Mach 2.2, facilitated by its aerodynamically refined design, which allowed it to outrun most adversaries. With a maximum ceiling of 45,000 feet, it could operate above most ground-launched anti-aircraft threats, thereby enhancing its survivability in contested airspace. With an operational range of approximately 2,000 miles without in-flight refueling, the EF-111A was able to project electronic warfare capabilities deep into enemy territory. What was a 1960s fighter bomber on its way to obsolescence had become a powerful and striking warplane. Its iconic look instantly made it recognizable, and its wingspan, variable between 63 feet when fully extended and 32 feet when swept back, made it an imposing sight. As the Gulf War began in January 1991, the Raven was deemed the perfect solution to shield coalition warplanes from the vast network of Iraqi air defenses. Despite its incredible capabilities, the F-111 Raven was not invulnerable. If an enemy fighter managed to get a lock on it and intercept it, the Raven did not have a single gun to defend itself. Operation Desert Storm was the perfect setting for such a nightmare situation. On January 17, 1991, Captains James Denton and Brent Brandini Brandon, at the helm of an F-111 Raven, spearheaded the critical opening air operation aimed at neutralizing the metal of Iraqi defenses. Their mission was razor-sharp in focus yet fraught with peril. Denton and Brandon had to hug the earth to shield the flock of coalition aircraft flying their electronic warhorse just a stone's throw from the ground, all while under the watchful guard of friendly F-15 Eagles and F-16 Fighting Falcons. These fighters were ready to swat down any Iraqi attempt to snag the Raven as it went about its business, jamming and confusing enemy radars for the coalition bomber and strike planes tasked with destroying the AAA and SAM positions. As the coalition forces pierced the veil into hostile skies, Denton nudged their Raven down to a scant 1,000 feet, melding with the Earth's contours. The rest of the strike force branched off, each set on their designated targets. The Raven sprang into action, unleashing a barrage of electronic countermeasures. Its sophisticated gear scrambled enemy sensors and radars, casting a veil of invisibility over the coalition fighters, throwing Iraqi forces into disarray, unable to lock onto their prey. But the enemy was quick to catch on to the disturbance in their electronic fields. In response, a flurry of MiG and Mirage fighters kicked off the tarmac, slicing through the skies to meet the incoming threat head-on. As the sun scorched the sands below, the skies above the Middle Eastern theater turned into a high-octane battleground. An F-15C Eagle pilot caught sight of an Iraqi Mirage F-1EQ, a supersonic adversary climbing to strike altitude. With no time to waste, the American pilot gave chase. Sensing the imminent threat on his six, the Iraqi pilot made a desperate play, launching a missile to shake off his pursuer. What ensued was a breathtaking dance, with both pilots jockeying for position. each striving to evade the other's lethal gaze. In a bid to escape, the Mirage pilot unleashed a flurry of flares and executed a sharp bank, momentarily throwing the F-15C off his trail. However, as he steadied himself from the maneuver, his eyes locked onto a new target, the low-flying Raven, oblivious to the battle unfolding above. Captains Denton and Brandini, deeply engrossed in their mission to blanket the coalition fleet with electronic protection, were caught off guard when their cockpit erupted with warnings. A missile had locked onto them. Instincts honed from relentless training took over. Denton yanked the Raven into a desperate dodge while Brandini, cool under fire, manned the countermeasures, spewing out a volley of flares into the thirsty desert air. Their split-second teamwork paid off. The Mirage's R-550 magic missile, deceived by the flare's heat signature, veered away, harmlessly exploding in the distance. The two Americans shared a moment of relief, their hearts racing and uniforms soaked in sweat. A brief interlude in the relentless tempo of war. But their victory was short-lived. The Mirage, like a predator denied its prey, wheeled around for another strike, its pilot determined not to let the Raven slip through his fingers again. Barely steadying from their heart-stopping evasion, Captains James Denton and Brent Brandini Brandon were once again in the crosshairs of the relentless Mirage, its pilot determined to bring down the unarmed Raven with his next assault. As the Mirage unleashed another magic AAM missile in their direction, Denton was forced into a gut-wrenching maneuver that threw both men deep into their seats. The force of gravity multiplied on their shoulders. With lightning reflexes, Brandon sent another hail of flares into the night, tricking death once more as the missile screeched past, a whisper away from catastrophe. With its missile stores spent, the Mirage, now bristling with rage and desperation, bore down on the Raven with its twin DEFA cannons primed, ready to deliver the final blow. The situation looked grim for the American duo. Without immediate support, they were moments away from being torn apart by a storm of 30mm shells. But Denton wasn't out of tricks. Armed with nothing but their wits and the Raven's electronic arsenal, he concocted a daring escape. Plummeting in a breathtaking dive, the Mirage hot on their tail, they skirted the very floor of the desert. With Brandon expertly navigating using the terrain-following radar, Denton piloted the Raven in a high-speed slalom, the ground a blur beneath them. In a maneuver that defied belief, Denton then pulled the Raven into a blistering vertical climb, throttles maxed, engines howling. Their adversary, caught in a lethal fixation and blinded by the dark low-altitude chase, failed to mirror the Raven's phoenix-like ascent. The Mirage, overwhelmed by the sudden loss of its quarry and the unforgiving terrain, met its end in a violent embrace with the desert floor as a massive fire sphere illuminated the otherwise pitch-dark skies over Iraq. Denton and Brandon, without firing a single shot, secured the F-111 Raven's first and only air-to-air kill, a feat of aerial prowess that would etch their names into the annals of aviation history. The F-111 Raven, with its unparalleled design and electronic warfare capabilities, cast a protective veil over countless coalition pilots' lives and stood alone as the only aircraft in the world capable of executing such a breathtaking feat. Its unique blend of supersonic speed, agility, and cutting-edge electronic countermeasures enabled it to dance on the razor's edge between victim and victor, proving that in the right hands, even an unarmed bird could wield the sky as its weapon.